Hello, my name is Chris, and today I'm going to review the 2019 Subaru Forester. A competitor to the CRVs and RAV4s of this world, this roomy entry comes in six trims. The entry 2.5i comes with wheel covers and is not worth mentioning. The convenience package adds 17-inch aluminum alloy wheels, 10-way power driver seat, dual zone climate control, fog lights, 6.5-inch infotainment that comes with CarPlay and Auto. The Touring has EyeSight driver assist technology with high beam assist and reverse automatic braking, proximity key with push button start, power sliding glass sunroof, big enough, and power rear tailgate with memory function. This sport version that you see adds steering responsive headlights, Subaru rear and side vehicle detection, 18-inch aluminum alloy wheels, sport aesthetics inside and out, and 8-inch touchscreen. There are two higher trim models which offer more luxury, though this sport trim appears to be a good value, and Subaru is one of the few manufacturers which offers mid-range models for the press fleet instead of the all-equipped versions. This is a sure sign of confidence that a manufacturer has in their products. Subaru is popular enough in Quebec and seems to be designed for our freezing winters. Check out Ross create a parking spot with Forester. The appearance of the interior is stronger than that of the exterior, with incredible space and convenience. The seats come down and lie flat, making transporting large items a breeze. Plenty of room in back, plenty of comfort. Nothing pampers a rear passenger quite like a big crossover. Very nice Subaru. In front, Forester is easy to use and spacious. This driving space is also easy to look out of. These features are consistent in all the Subarus I test drive. Brilliant. You almost have to sit in it and drive around on a day like today to truly appreciate the first-rate outward visibility. The interior design is fine, and the orange highlights give the sport model just enough character. The infotainment is simple to use, and the center stack setup is pleasing to gaze at and pleasing to use. This steering wheel is the same as on many Subarus, and comes with a cheap but seemingly tough leather that will last for years, I should think. The seats I felt were a bit disappointing versus something like CRV, and were not that comfortable. That could be a personal thing, try them out. The suspension is soft, and the four-wheel drive is reassuring in this weather. The engine is a four-cylinder boxer that makes 182 horsepower and 176 pounds of torque. It is mated to a CVT transmission, which performs well. The engine has to scream to pass at highway speeds, but you do get momentum as the CVT keeps the revs in the power band. It is inelegant, but not a deal breaker. 9 liters per 100 kilometers in the city and 7.2 liters on the highway is a very good score. Subaru used to be gas guzzlers, not anymore, though the engine start-stop is annoyingly rough. Here are my thoughts on the road. Hello, car lovers, driving the 2019 Subaru Forester. The sport version, pretty good pickup by Ross. What about this vehicle? Well, on the outside, this is what a traditional Subaru looks like. It's probably why I was never attracted to the brand. They've made some styling changes with their other models, not this one. But what are the plus benefits of having a styling this way? Is you have incredible functionality in terms of interior space. In terms of exterior visibility, this is like one big fishbowl. Really wonderful in terms of that aspect of the driving experience. So that's the exterior. If you like it, fine. If you don't like it, well, whatever.
On the, what's it like to drive? An extremely soft suspension, I find, for the category. Not molasses soft, but very soft. Very good for Montreal's shitty roads. Remember, we're the world heavyweight champions of shitty roads here in North America, and this vehicle is perfectly suited. What about the engine? Well, the engine is not the most powerful. It's a four-cylinder boxer. In the city, it's fine. For passing on the highway, I'd say it is fine. It just makes a ton of racket doing so, because it's got to go all out to give you that acceleration. On the inside now, the inside is a much improved story. I think Subaru did enough in terms of the interior presentation and quality. Horizontal surfaces are made of a relatively pretty good quality material for this category. There's that familiar Subaru easy to use quality when you step inside a Subaru. It's present in all the Subarus I try. It's wonderful. This steering wheel made out of the cheap leather. However, it feels like the durable leather. I think in 5 to 10 years, this will not show any signs of wear and tear. I could be wrong. The infotainment. Ross likes this infotainment. He's the one who really pays attention to that. I pay less attention to it. And what I love about an infotainment is a zero learning curve, an easy to use experience. This has it. It's just big enough, and the climate controls are separate from the infotainment, meaning if ever the screen gives out, you can still heat your car or cool it off during the summer. Very good, very good. I love this visibility. It's the second time I'm mentioning it, but it's really nice to drive, especially on this sunny day, this sunny winter day. You have a nice view of everything around. It's wonderful. What about the seats? I think this is where Subaru is perhaps behind others in terms of the seat comfort. Ross makes the remark it has a short seat bottom. For people with long legs, they're going to get tired. Expecting perhaps a little bit more of a captain's chair. Not distracting, but I think after an hour, you're going to be sick of it. The CVT does a good job. Mentioned it before. It does reasonably good fuel economy. For Canadians who are not familiar with the American market, Americans are pretty avid car shoppers. So for example, the Camry is very popular in the United States. No wonder. Reliable, comfortable, fuel efficient. We tend to see the United States through the eyes of the media, that is to say the coasts. But there's everything else in the middle. And there is the Rust Belt in the United States. The Rust Belt basically means the areas in the United States where they put salt on the roads, right? And which means they have snow. And when I drive to New York City, I pass through all of upper state New York, and I am always flabbergasted to see how many people actually have Subarus. It's one of the most popular vehicles, actually. So really makes an impression with some of the smartest shoppers on the planet, the American car buyer. And a lot of Canadians like Subaru too, because guess what? Winter. So I think Subaru is really a winter company in terms of their four-wheel drive, in terms of their functionality, and they make sense. So speaking about it with Ross before, he thinks they're recommendable on the lease on the purchase. I think they're recommendable on the lease on the purchase, and that is the review. By the way, if you like this review, like it. If you don't like it, don't like it. And if you really like it, you should subscribe. Duh. And also, if you're going to buy crap on Amazon, you can use my affiliate links in the commentary. It's good for Canadian customers and American customers, and it doesn't cost you anything, and it's a way of supporting the channel. I get to buy perhaps a new video editor, for example, and it costs me less money. And you know what? You're going to buy something using my affiliate link, and you're going to feel really good after. You're going to have a really good feeling inside. And that is it.